Hi, Kelly Rees with TrackStar1.com and Ignitemedia.
TrackStar1.com!
Today we're going to talk to you a little bit about helmet technology and proper fitment. This right here is a showy, top of the line showy from 1979. This is brand new out of the box. A friend of ours found it in the back of his garage and brought it in. This is the new showy RF1200. As you can see, there's a completely different shape to the helmets. The newer helmets are designed in wind tunnels and they're designed for proper venting. The old helmets were designed for strictly nothing more than to protect your head. You see that there's two little tiny vents on the front of this helmet. That's all you got back then. Now this is all you hear about. Front vents, rear vents, chin vents. I mean, it's all about keeping cool and still protecting your head. They've come a long way in the last few years. So let's talk a little bit about the different helmet technologies, because we get a lot of people come in the shop and they want to spend $99 on a helmet and they honestly can't understand why a helmet could possibly cost $900. There's a lot of differences in the helmets. You go from a $99 helmet, $160 helmet, they're usually made out of blow molded polycarbonate, which is a plastic. You get up in the 400 and up helmets and you're usually dealing with either a fiberglass or a fiberglass Kevlar carbon fiber mixture for the shell. Completely different construction. They absorb and disperse energy a little bit different. The more you spend on a helmet, the more you get out of a helmet. There's just no way around it. The liners are more comfortable. The venting is better. The shell itself is better. Yes, they all pass the same safety test they do as long as they're gotten snow rated. Spend as much money as you can possibly afford on your helmet. You only get one head. This right here is a blank shell from a ride. These things are amazing. If you ever get into a shop that's got one of these, take a close look at it and you can see what really goes into a more expensive helmet. Again, a plastic helmet is just a molded plastic shell. A fiberglass helmet or carbon helmet in the higher price range, they're very well engineered. You can look at these and see that there's several different types of laminated material in different sections of the helmet. They've done a lot of research onto where impacts are on helmets and how the impact energy is dispersed through the helmet. They engineer different weaves of fiberglass in different areas to absorb that energy. They're also much lighter because they can engineer this so that the weight is lower down in the helmet, so there's not as much leverage on your neck and the helmet feels much lighter. Okay, so helmet fitment. There's different shell shapes and sizes throughout the brands. There's a round, an intermediate oval, and a long oval. Nobody has the same shaped head, and a lot of people come in and think that they need an extra large because their large is pushing on their forehead. Well, they're actually a large, they're just in the wrong shell shape. When people come in looking for a helmet, I try to get them to try on one size in three different shaped shells. Generally, we find one shaped shell that fits their head correctly, and then we can go shopping by brand or by graphic. When you're looking for a helmet, you need to understand that the guy selling you the helmet can't feel your head inside that helmet. We don't know where it's tight, where it's loose, or anything, so you really need to kind of educate yourself on what you're feeling inside the helmet. What you want is even pressure all the way around the crown of your head. You don't want anywhere where it's pushing extremely hard, creating what we call a hot spot. We can usually see them when you take the helmet off, you'll have a red dot here on your forehead. We don't want to have that. We don't want to have any gaps or any spaces. My wife, for example, if we put her in a certain brand of helmet, it's really snug through here, but she'll have about a half an inch gap on her forehead. So we have to put her in a different shaped helmet. If I put her in a long oval, she has large gaps on the front and the back of the helmet and it's super tight on the sides. So what we want to do is try on several different brands and several different shapes of shells and find the one that works right for you. Technology on these helmets, on the interiors, has come a long way. We now have dry wick fibers, we have extremely comfortable liners. They're designed to be more aerodynamic. They have cuts in the sides so that they're more aerodynamic with less noise. You don't get the wind buffeting when you're in a tuck or when you turn your head to look behind you. The helmets tend not to grab. Spend the money on as much helmet as you can buy and you'll be far more comfortable. I tell people, if you spend $100 on a helmet, you're going to wear it this summer. By the end of the summer, it's probably going to be so uncomfortable that you're going to buy another $100 helmet the next year. and another one the next year. Go drop $300, $400, $500 on a good quality helmet, and 3 or 4 years from now, it's still going to feel the same when you put it on. Also, most of those helmets have a pretty consistent liner style, and you can just buy a replacement liner or wash the one you've got when it gets worn out. Then your helmet's like brand new again. I'll tell you why it's so important to have the correct fit. Just having the shell wrapped around your head is not everything that you need to protect yourself in a crash. The reason that we want the helmets fairly snug on your head is to create one impact rather than two. When you have an impact, this helmet's had several. This one I tumbled down straight away at Miller for quite a long ways and hit my head in about 8 different spots. When that helmet comes in and takes the impact, the liner inside and the outer shell is designed to absorb that energy around the helmet so that you don't have more hard impacts on your head. Now, if your helmet doesn't fit correctly and you have a 1/4-inch gap between your head and that EPS liner, then the helmet hits, starts to absorb the energy, then your head hits the inside of the liner, which is not designed to absorb energy that way. Impact one is the helmet, impact two is your head inside the helmet. That completely destroys the whole theory behind how these helmets are designed to work. That's why helmet fitment is so important. So, when you go to buy your new helmet, budget for it, do your research on what's going to work best for your situation, whether you're on the track, on the street, sport, touring. Do some research on reviews of the helmets, find out what's going to work for you. Save up what you can, go to a qualified helmet store that has a good helmet tech.